Age-related macular degeneration, or AMD, is the leading cause of blindness in patients over 60 years of age. Though external factors can contribute to the severity of disease, genetic predisposition is really the underlying why someone develops disease and symptoms. Certainly in our region, it's a common cause of sight loss. There's a complex variety of ways AMD can affect your vision. To simplify the issue, your retina specialist will diagnose you with exudative, or wet, and non-exudative, or dry disease. The wet form simply means there's evidence that a blood vessel has grown underneath the retina and is leaking fluid. It's this fluid that can cause a distortion of the anatomy and the change in the vision that patients describe as waves or a blind spot in their central field. The dry or non-exudative form can cause similar vision symptoms. However, it may take months or even years for these symptoms to manifest. Once diagnosed with exudative or wet disease, the surgeon will prescribe a medication that's delivered to the eye, usually at the same visit. This medication is delivered by injection into the eye every 4 weeks initially. These medications and procedures have been developed since 2001. Today, it's the most common procedure done in ophthalmology offices all over the world. In fact, it's estimated over 7 million injections are given every year. These medications have been nothing short of miraculous in our battle against vision loss and AMD. For the first time, we can salvage and in most cases improve vision in patients struggling with a blinding disease. Still, the prospect of receiving an injection in the eye is daunting for all our patients. We try to alleviate the fear by addressing the four A's: anxiety, anesthesia, aseptic technique, and aftercare. We discuss the procedure step by step so they can know exactly what to expect during and after the procedure. We also ask patients to help themselves by performing what's called box breathing to decrease their stress and hopefully reduce the anxiety. Many of my patients say that the most anxiety-provoking part of the procedure is the pain they might experience. We provide viscous lidocaine to provide topical anesthesia that begins to work in just seconds. Although patients can't believe it, most people say they experience pressure and minimal or no discomfort. As with any invasive procedure, we worry about introducing an infection to the eye. To prevent this complication, we use a topical betadine to remove bacteria from the ocular surface. While it's great at reducing the threat of infection, it is an irritant to the ocular surface and may result in some mild to moderate discomfort that starts about 30 minutes after the procedure and usually is improved in 24 hours. Mild and moderate irritation and the appearance of transient floaters are common expectations after the procedure, and both should remit after the procedure. We ask that patients be very careful and not get any dirt or dust on the ocular surface and to avoid submerging in any body of water to prevent infection. Most importantly, we remind our patients that we're available to them 24/7 for their concerns and any symptoms they might be experiencing. As with anything else, the thought of the injection is likely the worst part. However, the experience is much easier than people expect. Unbelievably, what seemed like a very drastic procedure becomes something you don't even think about. While most patients come in for treatment alone and return to their daily routine, we do recommend having someone there with you for your first treatment visit if possible. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact us at the Medical Eye Center.